In what ways does your media product use, develop, or challenge forms and conventions of real media product? In my music video, I felt like it was ideal to use different kinds of camera angles. This was to keep my target audience appealed, as if they were seeing the same camera angles in a different cut, they would become bored. I think the use of camera angles worked well due to the fact the song will have a slow pace. I didn't want the music video to become slow, as well as this would become repetitive. I also was sure to use a lot of close-ups of the artist, as Goodwin says it is vital to use them consistently in order to make the artist in the video the main characters. As I wanted my music video to link in with the story in the song, Grow Old With Me, synchronous sound is commonly well used in the music industry. I use this to keep my audience entertained by the upbeat music in some parts with the fast moving and editing and pacing my music video. I wanted this to link to the Verne Alice, as she says, words are largely transformed by image and sound. She also says the video must have a main lead singer in the video. I feel like I succeeded in this due to the fact that my song may dazzle the audience users, as they may not know what the lyrics are trying to intend. As I matched a visual to a target audience, I have let them have a better understanding of the meaning through the video. Here is an example of Eliza Doolittle's video. I followed the cultural stereotype of a teenage boy fashion sense. This meant that the boy was wearing skinny jeans and a standard top with trainers. In my video, there was a numerous amount of characters, as I was following Goodwin's theory. As he says, there are links between the lyrics and visuals. The cultural stereotype was a boy in the country. This is common in this day and age due to the fact that more artists are recording their videos outside. All questions whether the media include music videos with anything other than conventional representations. In the case of my music video, I feel that it's important to do so due to the song's lyrics show itself to this kind of representation. There is also an example of Passenger, as he is the only one in his music video as the main character. Now I'm going to speak about the develop of my movie making. I didn't want to use any sort of dance routine or moving in time as the other artists in my video. I didn't want to use this method in order to make my video successful. As Archer says, choreographed movements are common features of music videos. I went against this theory. I didn't want my video to seem staged but natural. I gave my artist a very simple task on how I wanted him to move. This would usually happen on the spot. I decided what I thought would fit in with the music video and that would be fine. I liked the idea of the video not being prepared and organised, not like a One Direction music video. I have used Birdie as an example of the sort of video I made for my own. Vanilla says in a music video there should be a connection to establish between the title and the activities of the character. I considered this and used her theory in my music video. As I wanted the audio to link in with the video, I had flashbacks which I used a grey and a white effect on. This was parts of the character's past life. This made a connection to the audience to help them understand the video in a better way. The activities the character took part in whilst filming was parts of his childhood, for example when he was running across the stepping stones and climbing through the trees. I used an example of Calvin Harris for this, as in his video he also has flashbacks and memories. I used common themes, however, I presented them in a different way. I used a crossover cut when the location would change. I also changed the effect on most parts of the video to sepia. This would bring more colour to the video and wildlife in the video. This gave more depth with regards to the narrative. I used an example of Bruno Mars of the crossover effect that he used in his video. The split screen was a challenge, as it was hard to get both of the artists to sing in the same time. Another challenge was making sure that the lip sync was perfect and in time. This links to Goodwin's theory, there is a relationship between the lyrics and visuals. I tried to make sure there was a relationship all the way through the video in which I feel I succeeded. I have rarely seen any other artist's music videos where they have used a split screen in order to tell a story. An example of an artist who had indeed used a split screen is Frank Ocean, Lost. However, he is not telling a story like I have tried to achieve in my video. He is simply showing the different locations in his music video. I think by using a split screen in my video, I did in fact break up the video and didn't make it boring and repetitive. I did not want to over-challenge the codes and conventions of real media projects because it would potentially alienate the viewer. This is a quote by Archer. I didn't want my video to be too much to look at. This would make the viewers not want to watch the video as they may find it dull. I would also contain a lot of effort to have the video fast and upbeat with choreographed movements. This is an example of Fatboy Slim's music video, which I find is too much for a music video. I wanted my music video to link in with Goodwin's theory of having the visual link with the lyrics. I'd done this by having some parts of the videos as memory which would be seen as the artist's past and childhood. I made this clear by having parts of the video in black and white which are supposed to be memories. This is like Ed Sheeran's music video, Give Me Love. He has scenes of a girl in his music video which is supposed to be a memory and he's having flashback. This has been followed by Goodwin's theory of the lyrics meeting the visual. I think Ed Sheeran has succeeded in this since he has made girl part of the music video, which clearly shows that he's having flashbacks.